Welcome back to Films Recapped. Today I will show you an action thriller film from 2016, called Hacksaw Ridge. Spoilers ahead, watch out and enjoy. Residing in the Blue Ridge Mountains of Virginia, Desmond grows up with his brother Hal, his very religious mother Bertha, and his father Tom, who used to be a soldier. Tom fought in the First World War and hasn't been the same since he got back. He drinks a lot, and his trauma makes him violent toward his family. Bertha has to tell his kids that their father doesn't hate them, he just hates himself. Desmond and Hal get along most of the time, and they go on adventures through the mountains together. But sometimes they fight, which Tom lets happen because then he only has to punish the winner. One afternoon, Desmond uses a brick to defend himself, and Hal almost dies in the process. The boy is lucky to be alive, but Desmond is shocked by the fact that he almost killed him. It doesn't help that his mother tells him that murder is the worst sin. 15 years later, Desmond is helping out at a church when he sees a man hurt on the street. He runs to help the man. After putting his belt around the man's leg as a tourniquet, Desmond takes him to the hospital, where the doctor praises Desmond for thinking quickly and saving the man's life. Desmond gets to see what nurses and doctors do and feel what it's like to save lives. He's always wanted to be a doctor but never got a good education. On the same day, he meets Nurse Dorothy and falls in love with her right away. He even agrees to give blood right away just to talk to her. The next day, Desmond dresses up and goes back to the hospital to ask Dorothy out and flirt with her. Their first date goes well. Even though Desmond is still learning how to talk to women, and Dorothy would have liked it if he had asked before kissing her without warning. Since then, they've become good friends, and Desmond has been able to learn more about medicine from the books Dorothy has given him. A few days later, Hal tells his family that he has joined the army to fight in World War II. He didn't tell them until after the fact because he knew they wouldn't agree with him. He turns out to be right. Bertha doesn't like the idea because killing goes against God's commandments, and seeing Hal in uniform triggers Tom's trauma, making him ask his son to leave the room. Shortly afterward, Desmond tells Dorothy he wants to enlist too, but as a medic. To make things right, he decides to ask Dorothy to marry him, and she accepts. The date they set is whenever he gets his first leave. Afterward, Desmond goes to talk to Tom, who is at the cemetery visiting the graves of his best friends that died at war. After ranting about how stupid they were, Tom says he doesn't want to bury his sons, too, and he doesn't think Desmond will be able to survive on just his beliefs. Dorothy gives Desmond a Bible with a picture of her inside on the day he leaves for Fort Jackson. When Desmond gets to the base, he meets all of his fellow privates, like Smitty, who plays with a knife and calls him Beanpole. Their assigned sergeant is Howell, who takes them all by surprise when he arrives with a shout, causing Smitty to drop the knife on his foot and not give time to another private to put on some clothes. Howell is the kind of stereotypical sergeant who yells at people for no reason and insults them about how they look, which Desmond finds pretty funny. The sergeant doesn't take the knife off Smitty's foot until he's done yelling. As punishment for not getting dressed on time, the naked soldier has to start training without clothes. During Desmond's training, his knots turn out wonky, but he excels at the obstacle course thanks to his life in the mountains. When it's time to learn how to use weapons, and he refuses to pick up a rifle, that's when things get really bad. Howell takes Desmond to see Captain Glover in his office. Desmond tells Captain Glover that he was told he wouldn't need to grab a weapon and that he wasn't supposed to be sent to a rifle company because he's a conscientious objector, though he thinks of himself more as a conscientious cooperator. He also says that because he is a Seventh-day Adventist, he can't work on Saturdays, which is their Sabbath. Glover finds the whole deal ridiculous, and thinking he can't trust Desmond in battle if he can't follow basic orders, he sends him to Section 8, psychiatric discharge. Afterward, Howell tells the other privates about Desmond being an objector in the most condescending way, pointing out he can't be depended on in battle. Before Desmond goes to bed at night, Smitty takes his Bible and tries to get him to hit him. Desmond doesn't react and says please to get his Bible back. Desmond goes through his psychic evaluation the next day. He says that he doesn't hear holy voices, that he knows he's different, but that he's just a strong believer and not crazy. The doctor decides that Desmond is fine and doesn't need Section 8. This means that he can legally work as a combat medic as long as he does well in all the other parts of his training. Still, Glover wants him to leave, so he tells Howell to keep Desmond in the barracks. Desmond is stuck doing hard work like cleaning toilets from then on. Howell also knocks Desmond's bed over as he tells everyone they won't have the weekend off, making it seem like Desmond is to blame. Because of this, when night comes, the other privates beat up Desmond while Smitty wonders why he's still there. Howell sees that Desmond is black and blue the next morning and tells him he should quit for his own good, but Desmond says no. He also won't tell the sergeant the names of the people who beat him up. In fact, he doesn't even admit he was attacked and says he got his bruises by accident. When the unit's training is over, everyone goes on leave except Desmond, who is arrested for not following orders. Dorothy is left waiting at the altar, but she knows something must have happened because Desmond would never do this to her. In his cell, Desmond ends up having a breakdown, but he stays calm when Glover comes to see him. The captain wants him to say he's guilty so he can get out of jail without being charged, but Desmond refuses because he's sure of what he believes. After that, Dorothy comes to see him and tells him to stop being so proud and pass the rifle training, which doesn't involve killing. Desmond still doesn't change his mind, thus Dorothy calls Tom and Bertha to share her worries. Later that night, Desmond has nightmares of the day he confronted his father while he was beating up his mother and how horrible it felt to take away his gun. The next day, Tom shows up at the fort wearing his old uniform and all of his medals. He wants to talk to his former commanding officer, who is now a brigadier general. Desmond pleads not guilty at his court-martial, but just as he is about to be sentenced, Tom forces his way into the courtroom. He brings a letter from the brigadier general reminding everyone that the American Constitution protects the right to be a conscientious objector. Because of this, the case is dropped to keep Congress from getting involved, and Desmond is allowed to start training as a combat medic. To celebrate, Desmond and Dorothy get married and have some time together. In 1945, Desmond's 77th unit is sent to Okinawa and deployed to the Pacific Theater. As soon as they get there, they see dozens of dead bodies being carried away in piles like trash, and they know that they are there to replace them. Glover's team gets the rest of the 96th unit, and Desmond meets the only other two medics in the area. They also get to hear about Maida Escarpment, better known as the Hacksaw Ridge. Americans have tried climbing it 6 times, but the Japanese army has managed to throw them off without fail. The enemy goes after people who are hurt on purpose, so Desmond has to take off his Red Cross and get a new helmet so he doesn't draw more attention to himself. The unit gets to Hacksaw Ridge a few days later. Getting it is very important because it will give them Okinawa, and if they have Okinawa, they have Japan. First, the American Navy attacks to confuse the Japanese army. After enough explosions and smoke have caused chaos, Glover's unit climbs up the ridge to fight. Both sides lose a lot of people in the battle, which is very violent. Desmond, on the other hand, is never scared and saves as many men as he can, even those who are usually left behind because they are thought to be lost cases. A few times, Japanese soldiers come close to catching him, but Smitty kills them all to keep Desmond safe. After many hours of fighting, night falls, and the American unit decides to dig in and set up camp to hold the spot they've taken. They plan to finish clearing out the ridge in the morning. Howell tells everyone that going out there alone is dangerous, so they should even pee in their holes, but Desmond still wants to look for survivors. When Smitty offers to cover him, Sergeant Howell lets him do it. Desmond does bring back a couple of soldiers before he goes into a hole with Smitty. Now that Smitty has seen Desmond in action, he treats him with much more respect, and the two of them even joke around. When Desmond goes to sleep, he dreams that the enemy will find their hiding place and kill them. Desmond tells Smitty about his dream after waking up on the verge of a nervous breakdown. Smitty is surprised to hear that a man won't pick up a weapon even in his dreams. Now seems to be the right time for Desmond to explain why he doesn't like holding guns. One night, when his drunk father was beating up his mother, he confronted him. Tom was holding a gun, but Desmond took it from him and pointed it at him. Tom fell to his knees crying, and Desmond felt like he had killed his father in his heart. On that day, he told God that he would never pick up a weapon again. In return, Smitty tells him that he never met his father and that his mother left him at an orphanage when he was young. The next morning, when the Americans had just woken up, the Japanese army launches a counterattack, which catches them by surprise. Howell tells everyone to move back, and the Navy comes to help. Unfortunately, Smitty dies before Desmond can get him to a safer place. The American army has no choice but to climb down the ridge, but Desmond doesn't go with them. He can hear the screams of the men left behind and has decided that God wants him to help them. Captain Glover takes the people who are still alive and leaves only a couple of soldiers to keep watch. Desmond pulls as many hurt soldiers as he can off the battlefield and lowers them down the ridge with a rope. A few hours later, Glover orders the artillery to stop so that more men don't die. This makes Howell, Desmond, and the other soldiers still up there visible to the Japanese and leaves them open to attack. Desmond is still not ready to give up. Jeeps are sent to pick up the soldiers he's lowering, but Desmond keeps going even as the Japanese soldiers get closer. A few minutes later, Desmond finds an injured soldier and buries him in the ground. Then, to hide, he puts a dead body over himself. The trick works, and the Japanese don't see them. Desmond is able to save his friend after all. While Glover begs a reluctant higher-up for more help, Desmond returns to the battlefield after dropping his latest save down the ridge, but this time, the enemy sees him. He runs away and ends up in a Japanese tunnel, where he meets a man who killed people to protect his honor. The enemies use this tunnel to move through the area, but Desmond is able to stay ahead of them until he finds a hurt Japanese soldier. Desmond gives him some morphine and a bandage, even though he is his enemy, because that is what the doctor told him to do. By the time he gets out of the tunnel, it's getting dark. Desmond doesn't let the darkness stop him from saving his fellow soldiers. He keeps doing this while praying to God and ignoring the blood on his hands. He even helps a few Japanese soldiers down. The next day, Glover is shocked to see that a lot of injured soldiers were brought in the middle of the night. He finally finds out from one of the saved men that the guy everyone thought was a coward has been doing this all by himself. Desmond, meanwhile, finally finds Howell with another soldier. After saving the private, he goes back for his sergeant. A Japanese sniper sees him and shoots at him, but his helmet stops the bullet. Howell still has a few bullets, so Desmond runs out on purpose to make the sniper shoot, which causes him to reveal his location and get shot by the sergeant. Then, Desmond starts pulling him away while Howell shoots at the Japanese soldiers who are now following them. Once Howell is lowered down the ridge, Desmond follows him and jumps. When Japanese soldiers peek over the edge to kill him, Glover and his men, who have come to help the last few survivors, shoot them. Desmond is treated with the utmost respect and taken back to the infirmary tents, where he learns that the other medic didn't make it. Later, Glover comes to see Desmond and says he's sorry for underestimating him. He admits that Desmond has done more for the country than anyone else. Glover also says that they will go back to the ridge the next day, which is Saturday. He would love to have Desmond with them, but he will understand if Desmond wants to keep his Sabbath. Desmond agrees to go, and the group waits for him to finish praying before attacking. The Americans catch the Japanese by surprise, and with the reinforcements that were finally given the green light in the tunnel that Desmond found, they quickly turn the battle in their favor. A small group of Japanese soldiers comes forward with a flag that says surrender, but they are just acting. They want to get closer to the Americans so they can throw a lot of grenades at them. Even though Desmond hurts himself when he deflects a grenade to save his team, the enemy soldiers are killed right away. Desmond's fellow privates put him on a stretcher and rush to get him away from the fight. They only stopped to give him his Bible back when they realized he had dropped it by accident. After the leader of the Japanese unit commits seppuku to make up for his mistakes, the Americans still win the battle and take over Hacksaw Ridge. On Hacksaw Ridge, the real Desmond Doss helped 75 people who were hurt get to safety. He was the first person to get the Medal of Honor, which is the highest honor for bravery under fire in the United States. Desmond and Dorothy were married until Dorothy died in 1991. Desmond was always modest about his heroic acts because he gave all the credit to his God and thought that the real heroes were dead. In 2006, when he was 87 years old, he died. Make sure to like, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you can watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.